Hey everybody, welcome back to Wind Up TV. The dialogue off camera was very interesting. Anyway, on today's show, I have the pleasure to have a few French winemakers send me samples in the mail. And I've got like a half dozen. We're going to do two of them today. We're going to do Bouvray, Chenin Blanc, and then we're going to do a Volnay, which is 100% Pinot Noir. So when we come back, we're going to listen to Monique talk about dirty stuff like she was talking to before we started this. And my ears are still on fire. I can't believe it came out of my mouth. I'll see you guys in a second. Princess. First one we're going to talk about is Vouvray, and I actually have Wikipedia up here. I want to do a little bit more history on the Vouvray region in France, and it's in the Loire Valley, and located in the Touraine district just east of the city of Tours in the commune of Vouvray, and they can only grow Chenin Blanc in this place. Chenin Blanc is one of those grapes. It's old school, a little bit grassy like a Sauvignon Blanc, generally speaking. And you can make them in different styles. You can have a sweet Vouvray, a demi-sec, a sec, or you can have a dry style. I haven't even had this one yet. But a little bit more history of Vouvray. Viticulture has existed in Vouvray since at least the Middle Ages when the Catholic Church maintained vineyards at the local monastery. Chenin Blanc grape, known locally as Pinot de la Loire, is believed to have originated in the Anjou wine region sometimes in the 9th century, and from there eventually migrated to Vouvray in the 16th and 17th century. So what we're going to be drinking here is a little bit of history, and these wines have no government warning labels on the back.
Which is fantastic.
In other words, you know that warning label, you know, you're not supposed to drink and drive, which is obvious, but if you drink too much, you can get pregnant. That's the only one the government has missed out on. So right now, we're going to do this wine. And this isn't even available here in the States. But Elaine is the guy that sent these over. And I met him he's one of my friends on LinkedIn. And he popped me an email, can I send you some wines to be reviewed on your show? How powerful is the internet? Here is somebody in France watching my program and sending me wines, reaching out to me, which is very cool. This is a Vouvray, the Val de Loire, the SEC 2008, mise en bouteille at the proprietor, and not much is in here. It's all in French.
it's so peachy.
Pel Pepe Le Pio. Exploration familière de Bitroy Generation. Okay, so this wine, let's talk about the Chenin Blanc grape.
Very fruit forward.
It is. It's got that grassiness, Yes. Almost like a Sauvignon Blanc.
But I get a lot of peach from it. Still the traditional fruit of a pear. It has a very floral nose as well, to me.
It does, and it's getting to a point where it's drinking. I think it's smelling like it's drinking well.
Yes.
Oh. Wow. This is rocking. I don't know, what do you think? Good acidity.
Too much acidity for me.
Can you say that fast four times?
Because I'm even still, it's still hitting me. If you like acidic wines, then this is definitely it.
But overall, though, Chenin Blanc can be a little bit acidic.
Yeah.
It doesn't taste like it's seen any oak.
This
is all stainless steel tank fermented,
and
I'm sure.
It does have that crisp appeal. It's still lingering in my mouth. But again, very acidic. This is like a regular Chenin Blanc.
I'm an ass man. The acidic part is good. I like how you acidic.
See, and like I'm opposite. I'll take.
You should be an ass man.
I am.
You're an ass man.
I do. Right. I like a big ass.
Ooh, she's gonna love me. It's amazing what you can get away with saying on these shows, huh? All right. So the wine, crisp, clean, good shellfish wine.
It's oysters. This is too citrusy, so I would definitely balance it out with a good fruit and chicken.
Do you like oysters in the half shell?
Oh, yeah. Good aphrodisiac as well. Yeah.
And then it looks like a labia almost. Love the oyster. Slim, you like the oysters?
No.
This is definitely...
We've got to get more culture.
I like clam, but...
Nice.
And I do prefer this a little bit warmer. So with a white wine, how you're having it, you know, at a 48 degrees to 54, I would typically have it at more room temperature.
Have you noticed, though, on all my wines, I always serve them at room temperature?
Yes, and I like that.
I do that because the flaws are hidden by the temperature of the wine.
Absolutely.
And I like to taste the fruit. Some people like their white wines a little cooler. Now, trust me, if I was just sitting around the house drinking this, I'd throw it in the fridge for about 20 minutes.
Absolutely.
Get a little bit of chill on, not a lot of chill on, and then kind of, you know, open up and pour it out and drink it.
But this will definitely benefit from being cooler for most people. It will actually take away so much of the acidity.
I have two bottles of this left. It's $150 a bottle because you can't get it here in the States. No, I'm just kidding. I don't know how much this is.
We don't know.
We don't know. And we don't care because, yeah, you know, we have people from around the country that are sending me wines. And I think that's the really cool thing. All right, the next wine we're going to have, this is 100% Pinot Noir. This is the 2009. 2009 is a very good vintage, very warm. And this is the Volnay, the Domaine Puyou-Père-et-Fils, and the Vielvine. So it's just a village wine. 100% Pinot Noir. So let's that label right there. Again, no warning labels on the backs. None of that. 2009.
We're giving you raw wine.
This is raw wine. It doesn't get more raw than this.
Oh my goodness!
Yeah, this is old school. This is Burgundy.
This is
a Burgundian wine.
This is where I wish we would see Oregon Pinot Noirs because I prefer this style.
You know, when you talk about what you just said, the Oregon Pinots, you know, they're more fruit driven.
Yes.
As in terroir driven, and this here. God, this smells great.
It does. It has still cologne. The earthiness. I know. It would make actually a good cologne.
Oh. 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 His fingers. The French hands tend to weave.
So with this one, you still get the cherry, but a lot of it is earth-driven.
And get that mushroomy forest floor. You know, a lot of people talk about
a mushroom risotto would be fantastic with this.
Joel Palmer House. You guys, if you ever come to the Willamette Valley, if you want to have dinner outside of Portland, in Dayton, Oregon, there's this little, beautiful little farmhouse called, have you ever eaten there?
No, I haven't.
Note to self. The Joel Palmer House, and the chef is great. His dad forages for wild mushrooms throughout the year. And wild mushrooms, whether they're chanterelles, morels, with Pinot Noir, it's just a combination that's just made for each other. And the Joel Palmer House has an amazing meal. And yeah, we've got to go out there sometime and have dinner out there.
That sounds good, but I mean, with this one, you'll even...
Imagine bringing a bottle. I got a couple of bottles of this, too.
I mean, this is something, go to the farmer's market, because now we're starting to get into the season where you can go to the farmer's market, pick up some fresh vegetables.
God, Elaine!
Together.
She's a little ghetto now and then. Together, you know what I'm saying? I'm finna hold over here together. Here. Oh, sister Sly. This wine right here, taste that. I love this kind of Pinot.
It's smooth. This is something...
kind of like me.
Yeah, very smooth. You know, like DJ Quick back in the 90s. Smooth.
I thought you were only 21.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
you were like 8.
That's right, I'm 21.
And you were like 8 when we were watching DJ Quick, right? No, you weren't even born. All right, so one thing I noticed with this wine, even though it's a VLV and it's just a village wine, it's just round, rich, and supple.
It is. And with balancing out the flavors in this one, I would actually use this with cooking as well. So
this is old school, folks. You know, it's earthy.
Mm-hmm.
It's what Pinot Noir is supposed to be. Not overly extracted, not overly ripe.
Right.
Great finesse, great tannins, great mouthfeel.
Oh yes,
it's just silky on the tongue.
I actually would like some chocolate with this too. It's really good.
Come on over, I'll make you a chocolate fountain. Spooing the chocolate. And I'll wear my chocolate underwear and we'll have a real chocolate
oh,
time.
Oh, perfect! Yeah. It sounds like a big chocolate.
Yikes!
Yeah,
it sounds like a mess to me. Oh, look at that! Well,
oh, whoa!
And the miracle
chocolate
of chocolate,
sky.
Ghirardelli, the San Francisco treat. So we're gonna actually have a piece of chocolate here because Monique loves chocolate. Here, Oh God, no. Isn't that just so disgustingly sexy? All right, so again, Slim, put up the name on the website. Domaine Puyol Per Afil Volnay. You guys are rocking it. Elaine, thank you very much for having your friend send me these wines. Whenever you want to send me more wine, God, that's chocolatey goodness, isn't it? Whenever your friends want to send me some wines, please don't hesitate and I'll review them. I love this wine. Mm-hmm. Put this on your website in France and then we'll go from there. Anyway, Monique, again, girl, we're going to rock this world together. One glass at a time. Cheers.